Hi everybody, welcome to today's webinar on ClinicalKey presented by the WRHA Virtual Library. My name is Nicole and I am one of the librarians with the Virtual Library. If you have questions at any point during this presentation, please feel free to use the questions feature in GoToWebinar to ask your questions. We will also have a dedicated time at the end of the presentation for any additional questions that people might have. This presentation is being recorded and it will be available to you afterwards, probably within one or two business days. We will also be sharing the slides with you, so don't worry about writing everything down. And with that, let's get started. So our objectives for the presentation today are to briefly talk about the WRHA Virtual Library and its services for those of you who might not be familiar with us. We're going to talk about what ClinicalKey is and how it can help you. I'm going to show you some of the different resources in ClinicalKey on desktop, and then we're going to talk about how to create an account and set up the ClinicalKey mobile app. So what is the WRHA Virtual Library? The library provides access to electronic resources and library services for WRHA staff members, as well as staff at eligible community health agencies and eligible personal care homes. If you're in one of those groups and you don't already have access, just get in touch with us. We'll be happy to help you get set up. The WRHA Virtual Library provides access to an array of electronic resources, including books, journals, videos, and databases like ClinicalKey. We also provide a number of library services. These include literature searches, document delivery for any resources that you want that we don't yet subscribe to, as well as education and training sessions like this one. So now that we've introduced the library, let's talk about what is ClinicalKey. ClinicalKey is one of the many databases that we have available through the library. It provides a health information database on desktop, as well as a mobile version that you can download on your phone or other device. It is an Elsevier product, and it has an extensive collection that includes full text books, journal articles, practice guidelines, procedure videos, multimedia, clinical overviews, drug monographs and class overviews, clinical calculators, and patient education materials. And we're going to be going over many of these items in more detail over the next few slides. So in order to get access to ClinicalKey, you can start from our website. The URL is down at the bottom of the screen there, and I would definitely recommend that you bookmark that for future easy access. You can access ClinicalKey through our collection list, which has all of the databases available through the WRHA Virtual Library. But we recommend you go through ClinicalKey under the Apps and Tools section, because this page has a little bit more information about some of the details that we're going to be covering today about creating an account, accessing on mobile, etc. So that page looks like this. When you log in, you may need to log in with your WRHA Virtual Library login in order to access. And again, if you don't have one or if you've forgotten the password, just get in touch with us. We'll be happy to help you out with that. Further down this page, you would see more information about creating an account as well as app access. I will mention that you don't need a separate account to access ClinicalKey on desktop. You can just use your regular WRHA Virtual Library login. But if you do want to use that app or some of the other advanced features, you may need to create a separate account on ClinicalKey in order to do that. And we'll be talking about that as well a little bit later. So this is what the ClinicalKey interface looks like on your desktop view. So you see up at the top right corner there, you've got your login and register options, and we'll be talking about that a little bit later. You have the continuing medical education option. If anyone is interested in that, that's where you would find that. You have this search bar in the center of your screen here. This is the main search bar for searching through the content available through ClinicalKey. And you can use that all types dropdown to specify what type of content you want to return. And you can also scroll down here through the various types of content that they have in order to browse through the clinical overviews, drug monographs, etc. So if you do a search, you end up in a page like this. So I did a search for gout, and I've got just over 11,000 results on that. This page is currently sorted by relevance, but you could change it to sort by date instead if you prefer that. So in the middle column there, you see the different results that you have for this particular search. At the top of each result set, you see what type of result it is. So the first one here is a clinical overview, and the second one is a full text article. You can also jump to specific sections within the result if they have them. For example, that first one, you could jump to the summary or diagnosis, etc. And then in that second one there, you have an example of the jump to PDF option. So you can click on that little PDF icon to get directly to that result in PDF form. And over on the left-hand side here, you've got your different options for filtering your results. So 11,000 is a lot of results, and it might be a little bit to go through. So you can use these options to filter down. So for example, I can filter by source type, I can limit to journal articles, and I can even limit to specific types of journal articles if that's what I'm interested in. For example, I could do randomized controlled trials versus meta-analyses. And I've got all my other source types as well, with a few more down under that more source types at the bottom there. So we've got guidelines, patient education, etc. Below that, you have an option to filter by specialties. So for example, if you are interested in a rheumatology perspective versus a musculoskeletal perspective, that would be where you would be able to filter that way. And below that, you can't see it on this screen, but there's an option to filter by date as well. So if you want to limit your results to items from the last 5 years, for example, that's where you would do that. So here's an example of a result from a book chapter. So this particular search was for pneumonia. And you can see up at the top there, you can actually find specifically where in this chapter or in this book that term appears, if it wasn't so obvious as being the title of the chapter, as it is in this case. Over on the left-hand side there, you have your options to go through the different headings that are within this particular result, and you'll see that that feature persists throughout all most of the different result types. So if you saw a journal article, it would have a similar thing to help you navigate through the article. And then over on the right-hand side, you've got the full text from which this result appears. So in this case, Roslyn's Emergency Medicine, I could click on that in order to go to the full book and see all of the other chapters that are available. This is an example of one of the clinical overviews that is available. So clinical overviews provide a one-stop shop for you to quickly get an overview of a particular condition or treatment option. In this case, we're looking at the condition of acetaminophen toxicity. So you've got a key point synopsis up at the top, which is really helpful to give you a very quick overview of the topic area. And it also highlights some urgent actions that you should take if you're facing a patient with this particular condition. And then again, over on your left-hand side there, you can see the different headings that you would be able to page through on this result. So for the clinical overviews, you start with that synopsis that gives you those key points to keep in mind. And then you go through the terminology, diagnosis, management, treatment options, all of that. So all of that is available in this interface. These are updated fairly regularly. So you can see that update date up at the top there. It's July 20th, 2021, so not that long ago. So these provide a really great up-to-date overview, similar to what you'll find in the up-to-date database of a particular condition. This is an example of one of the drug monographs. So you have indications and dosage administration information, contraindication and interaction information as well. So it's a really good quick overview of the details of this particular drug. And you can also find a similar thing for drug classes, a more general overview of the class and more information about the details to know for that particular class of drugs as well as the specific drug. So this is an example of one of the clinical calculators, and these are really useful because it actually provides not only the information about how to make the calculation, but you can actually fill it out and develop the calculation within the interface itself. So you could fill out these numbers here and get your results, and you can even specify what precision of results. So this is really useful, and you don't see it on the screen, but further down the page there is information on references where this clinical calculator came from. So if you wanted to cite a particular calculator, for example, that would be a really useful tool for helping you find out where it's coming from. Here is an example of one of ClinicalKey's procedure videos. This particular one is on stress testing on the exercise treadmill. They have an extensive collection, particularly for various surgical and procedural videos, which are very helpful. Not only do they have the videos up at the top here, but they also have information further down the page on the procedure step by step, what equipment you need for the procedure, that sort of thing. So it's really useful if you need to quickly familiarize yourself with a particular procedure. And as with the clinical overviews, these are regularly reviewed and updated. So this particular one was last reviewed in April. They're regularly updated, so they're really up to date in terms of the latest best practices for procedures. So that's really useful for you as well. This is an example of one of the patient education options. So again, here we've got down the left-hand side our different features, what are the causes, what are signs and symptoms, follow these instructions at home. But over on the right-hand side there, you can print this out to provide it to a patient, and you can print it out in other languages as well. So this is a super useful option if you have a patient whose first language is something other than English. You can review the content yourself in English to understand what the patient is being told, but then you can select one of those other language options and it'll give you a printout version in that language for the patient. So for example, if you had a patient that spoke Korean, you don't speak Korean, you review this version in English and then you click on that to provide them with that version in Korean. Because it's a US-based resource, a lot of the resources are in Spanish, but as you can see here, there's an extensive collection of other languages as well. So this is an example of the multimedia section, and this is a really cool option because when you click on any of these multimedia files, you see down at the bottom there, view and source, so it provides you a link to which journal or book that this particular item came from. And you can click on that to be able to see this item in the context of that book or chapter or whatever it is. It also provides you with a full citation for this particular item. So most of the things that we've gone through so far, you don't need an account to take advantage of, but I did want to flag a couple of items here that are available only to those of you who've created an account, and we'll talk about how to do that in just a moment. But you see to the right of that image, that little star icon that allows you to save that content for your own later use or to share with someone else. And then to the right of that, there's that little rectangle with a triangle at the bottom of it. It's not a very intuitive icon maybe, but that is the presentation icon. So when you have an account in ClinicalKey, you have access to what's called a presentation maker. And this allows you to import images from ClinicalKey into a PowerPoint presentation for you to deliver. Now, you're allowed to do this without having to pay as long as you keep that copyright information that you see under that image and as long as the presentation you're delivering is for non-commercial purposes. So if, for example, you want to deliver a presentation for Grand Rounds, you want to do a continuing education session for your colleagues that is not commercial in nature, then this is a great option for getting images for that because these are from reliable sources and are generally providing full information about how to cite them and how to credit the copyright. So that's a great option for you as well. So as I mentioned, that particular option does require that you create an account. So up at the top right-hand corner of the ClinicalKey interface, you will see that login and register button. So you would click on register in order to create your account. And you would see a form that starts out like this. You would fill in your name and your email address. Your email address for ClinicalKey is going to be your username for all Elsevier products. So if you've previously used another Elsevier product and there's a link there that shows you the list of what those are, you might already have an account. In which case, great, you don't need to create a new one. You could just continue to use that one. But your ClinicalKey or Elsevier account is separate from your WRHA Virtual Library account. So be sure to remember what your password is because we can't reset it for you. It'll be whatever you set in this form here. So once you have created your account, you will see this menu option on the right-hand side of your screen when you're in ClinicalKey. So this is where you get access to your continuing medical education if you're pursuing that option. This is where you could change the language of the interface if you wanted to do that. This is where you would access your saved content if you've saved any content using that star icon that I showed you on those images there. And that icon actually does appear on all other content types as well, not just images. So you can save pretty much any type of content for you to review later. This is where you would access that presentation maker feature that I mentioned earlier. So you can save those images and create a presentation within ClinicalKey to help you develop a presentation for Grand Rounds or whatever. But then we have this remote access option. And this is what you would need to enable if you want to use the mobile app for ClinicalKey. So when you click on the remote access option, you will be asked to enter an email address. Now, you will need to enter an institutional email address rather than a personal email. So if you try to use a Gmail or a Hotmail or whatever type of email address, it won't work correctly. So keep that in mind when you're filling this out. It needs to be an institutional email address, like you're at HSC, at SBGH, whatever else you might have. If you don't happen to have an institutional email address, get in touch with us and we'll see if we can work something out for you. Or if you enter an email address and it doesn't work, same idea. We actually had to set up each of the institutional email options individually, so it's very possible that we missed some along the way. So if your email address that you need to enter, you don't have an institutional email address, or yours is not working in this interface, just get in touch with us and we'll be happy to fix that for you. So once you have got that remote access option set up with your email, what you're going to need to do to access the app is you're going to make sure, first of all, you have that account with remote access. You remember what the email and password is that you set up with it. You're going to download ClinicalKey on whatever device you might happen to have, whether that's through the App Store or through the Google Play Store, what have you. You're going to go through the setup options on that app. You're going to select the Global Edition, and you're going to select ClinicalKey. Now, you might see ClinicalKey for Nursing or ClinicalKey Pharmacology within the app. Don't select either of those. That's a slightly different version from what we have access to, so those won't work with your account. So just select the main ClinicalKey, and then enter the login and password that you set up when you were setting up your account on the desktop version. So this will be the account that you set up, not your WRHA Virtual Library account. Different login. So keep that in mind as well. If you run into any problems with this process, again, please feel free to get in touch with us. We're always happy to help you figure things out. But once you've done this, you should be able to use the app, and it gives you access to basically all of the content that you would see on desktop just through the app version. The other thing I will mention with regards to the remote access option is, if you set up remote access, it allows you to not have to go through the WRHA Virtual Library login on a regular basis. You can actually just go directly to ClinicalKey and log in there with the login that you've set up. But you will need to go back through the WRHA Virtual Library, I think it's every 180 days. You might be familiar with this if you've previously used the UpToDate app or LexiComp as well. You regularly have to re-verify that you're still affiliated with the WRHA Virtual Library. So every 180 days, you have to log in through the library website on desktop, and then that'll allow you to continue accessing the app. So that brings us to the end of our tour of ClinicalKey. I'll hang out here for a few minutes to see if anybody has any questions. Otherwise, please feel free to get in touch with me. My email's up there on the screen, and I'm always happy to help. Thanks, everybody.